Exporting a model from Blender to a game engine can go wrong in many ways. I'm doing this video as a reference guide for myself and anyone who needs a reminder on how to export their model to either Unity, Unreal Engine, or Godot. I have this low poly squirrel that I made for a game jam and it'll be perfect for this tutorial. First, let's go through a checklist of essential steps for the model before exporting. Then we'll go through the export settings and pick the specific options for each game engine. Let's get started. Do you have a spare of your model? It's always good to have a backup of your mesh in case you apply some modifiers or mess something up. Make sure to duplicate it and add it to a collection that you can hide. If something goes wrong, you can easily go back to your spare and make a copy. How many faces does your model have? This depends on a few factors: the complexity of the details, what will it be used for, and the type of game it'll be in. Enable the statistics, and make sure it doesn't have an absurd number of faces. A small coffee mug sitting on a table in the corner of a room won't need as many faces as a rigged character. Only add faces when the model needs more details. Otherwise, keep it as low as possible. Is there any end guns? End guns are faces that have more than 4 vertices. So basically more than 4 sides. These faces might have a hard time shading correctly in your game engine. A cylinder can have end guns on each end and it won't matter because the faces are flat. But end guns won't render properly if they're not planar. To see if you have any unwanted end guns on your model, here's a simple trick. Go to Edit Mode, choose Face Select by pressing 3 on your keyboard, then use the shortcut Alt-A to deselect everything. Now go to the Select menu, go to Select All by Trait, and choose Faces by Sides. A menu will pop up at the bottom left corner, and change Equal to Greater Than. This will select all the faces that have more than 4 vertices. An easy way to see them properly is by pressing Alt-Z to go into X-ray mode. Fixing end guns can be tricky, and it's a task that might need its own video, but we'll get to it. So make sure to subscribe. Is your model UV unwrapped properly? UV unwrapping ensures that the texture is applied correctly. By adding a UV grid to your model material while you UV unwrap, you can better visualize where your model texture needs to be adjusted. To create the UV grid, go to the UV Editing tab and click on New in the Image Editor panel on the left. You can name it UV Grid and under Generated Type, select UV Grid. After that, go to the Shading tab and create a new material. Press Shift-A and search for Image Texture. From the drop-down menu of the Image Texture node, select the UV Grid image you created in the UV Editing tab. Now link the Image Texture color socket to the base color of the principled BSDF. And voila! Go back to the UV Editing tab to UV unwrap your model with the visual help of the UV Grid. Don't forget to choose Material Preview to see it. Is the origin placed properly? The origin of your model will be the pivot point in your game engine. By assigning the origin to your desired pivot point now, it'll make it easier to manipulate your game asset later when designing your game. You can go into Edit Mode, select a vertex that feels like a good pivot point, press Shift-S to load the Snap menu, and choose Cursor to Selected. This will place your 3D cursor directly on your selected vertex. Now go back to Object Mode, right-click your model, go to Set Origin, and choose Origin to 3D Cursor. Now your pivot point is set to your desired location. You can also select multiple vertices and do the same steps. It will place the origin point in the middle of all the selected vertices. Be careful, some modifiers use the origin point, so if you move it, it might alter your model. Is your model triangulated? If you export your model from Blender with all quads, the game engine will convert all the faces to triangles. This is fine, but there's two different ways to triangulate a quad. You're better off exporting your model in triangles so that materials and animations aren't affected by the engine's triangulation. There's a non-destructive way to do this so you won't even see it while modeling. Simply add the Triangulate modifier. Otherwise, you can select all the faces in Edit Mode and press Ctrl-T to triangulate the selected faces. Now that our model is good to go, we can start the exporting process. Make sure your model is selected, and you'll see why in a few seconds. For Unity and Unreal, go to File, Export, FBX. In the Export Settings window, you'll see a bunch of options on the right side. Let's start from the top. Operator Preset is your settings that you can save. You should have a preset for every type of game asset you'll be making, whether it's a simple Unity game object or a rigged character for Unreal Engine. This will save you a lot of time, so we'll come back to it before exporting. Next, you have the path mode. Choose copy and click the icon next to it called emp texture. This will copy any external textures, so if you send your model to a colleague, they'll receive the textures with it. For object types, this will depend on the object. If it's just a simple object with nothing else, check mesh. But if you have an armature for animations, hold shift and click both armature and mesh. Now let's go to transform. This is where Unity and Unreal will have different settings. For Unity, set the scale to 1. Unity uses the same scale as Blender, 1 unit equal 1 meter. Apply scalings to all local, set forward to Z forward, set up to Y up. Now for Unreal, set the scale to 0.01, 1 unit equal 1 centimeter in Unreal, while in Blender 1 unit equal 1 meter. Apply scalings to FBX unit scale, set forward to minus X forward, set up to Z up. Now the upcoming changes are good for both Unity and Unreal. Make sure to check Apply Transform to ensure your object is facing forward in the game engine. In the Geometry section, choose a Smoothing Face. Normal only will most likely work, but Smoothing Faces seems to be the best option. Make sure to apply modifiers. And if you forgot to triangulate your model, you can do so here by checking Triangulate Faces. If you have an armature and animations, go to the Armature settings and check Only Deform Bones and uncheck Add Leave Bones to keep only the essential bones for your rig. Under Animation, check everything if you have any animations. Now go back to the Operator presets at the top and save it with a name that applies to your model. I'll name mine Unity No Animation. Choose a location and a name for your file and export. Then you can simply import your model into your game engine. For Godot, you can export as FBX, but you might run into issues. The best format for Godot is GLTF. Let's go through the settings. Go to File, Export, GLTF 2.0. In the export settings, you'll choose the format either GLB or GLTF. I know we picked earlier GLTF, but here, you'll want to choose GLB. This will include textures and animations in the same file. If you choose GLTF, they'll come in separate files, which can be useful in certain conditions. For this video, we'll use GLB. You can click Remember Export Settings or create a preset at the end. In the Include tab, only check selected objects. Then in the Transform tab, make sure Y up is checked. Now go to the Mesh tab and check Apply Modifiers, UVs, and Normals. Leave the rest as is, and Blender will create the file accordingly, whether you have animations or not. Save your preset, choose a location and the name, then export it. Drag and drop it into Godot and you're done. I hope this video was useful for you. I'll see you at the next game jam. See ya.